Everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in San Diego at the Half-moon Bay Marina. This is a 2002 Hunter 326, so let me show you some of the features and benefits that this boat has to offer. Here is glory, and as you can see, it is a beautiful blue painted hull with blue bottom paint. The bottom paint was just done, and in the link to the listing, you'll see all of the upgrades that have been tastefully done on this vessel, keeping it in pristine condition for its age. As we walk around, you're going to notice that the 326 has a nice tall cabin top to it and large windows. So we're down below, you're going to get great headroom and really good visual outside of the boat, natural light. As we work our way back, you're going to notice that this has the stainless steel arch on it. So a nice upgraded feature here. Also has the traveler built into the top of the arch and controls that allow you to control the traveler here behind the wheel with great access to your jib sheets. Vessel also has a nice stainless steel davit system here off the back of it, and flexi teak on the stern and throughout the cockpit. But a nice swim platform here, as you can see, really nice storage area. And again, just a great use of space for this size of a vessel. As we make our way up to the foredeck, you can see built-in stainless steel grab handles. Everything's led back into the cockpit. Again, we have nice overhead opening hatches that have been recently replaced, so they're in perfect condition with no crazing. And one thing that makes this nice and unique is the windlass is a up and down Simpson Lawrence windlass. We have a nice anchor locker located there. Single bow roller, furlex furler for the head sail. Two-tone decks, which make it really nice for visual and walking up to the foredeck and back. Get nice deck organizers, a Selden rod kicker, in-mast furling with UK sails. We have the digital radar, radar reflectors, and Hunter's famous B&R rig. As we look back aft into the cockpit, you can see for a boat of this size, this is a massive cockpit. Again, comparing it to older models, the vessel has a massive cockpit, great headroom, and a lot of livability and maneuvering space. We have a hatch here underneath this seat that leads into the aft cabin. So when you're in the aft cabin, this will lift up, giving you ventilation. And the cockpit cushions, and as you can see, the flexi teak underneath them. Stern rail seats, great access to the transom of the boat. So this will actually lift out of place so you have a full walkthrough if so desired. We have our RPM gauge off to the starboard side, a single controller for our throttle transmission, our autopilot, which is a wheel-mounted autopilot. We have the compass, wind point wind speed, depth, speed, and our hybrid touchscreen GPS plotter. There's one here and down below with radar integration on top of the plotter function as well. Just forward of the pedestal is the cockpit table. It has two starboard leaves that open up on both sides. And then as we make our way down below the vessel, you can see again what I was talking about with that large headroom, lot of natural light, great visual outside of the boat itself. There is the galley off to the starboard side. The galley has a icebox located here. So pretty large, deep icebox. If you wanted a cold plate and a refrigeration system, that could easily be done. That was an option. Lots of storage. There is a two burner stovetop, microwave, a large stainless steel sink, dedicated trash can below this. And again, Corian countertops, nice wood fiddles. Directly across from us is the aft cabin. There's a large storage and hanging locker here. And again, as we move back into the aft cabin, you can see just how large this berth is. And then overhead is that opening hatch, really giving you that ventilation and just that open feel above where your head would be. Teak and holly floors, beautiful teak wood interior. And again, large seating throughout. This is the head and shower compartment located here. The Japsco manual flush toilet. This table will actually drop down and turn into a berth. We have the filler cushion down below here, but the fabric is in really good condition. Handholds there, there are shades that cover the windows. And then at our nav station, we have the master hybrid touchscreen chart plotter. We have a Jensen stereo, ICOM, VHF, our 110, our 12 volt breaker panels, and our tank monitoring systems. Storage underneath all of the seating. And as we move up forward, these two doors can close off this forward V-berth cabin. And what I like about this design is the bed itself, the filler part can be removed. So you actually can walk up into this cabin. There's storage located under here. And again, nice overhead hatch that allows you great visual of your anchor chain and road. And then we have a hanging locker closet here. There's also this really cool little louvered door. So this can open up too, making it feel really open throughout the vessel. So it'll give you a nice perspective looking aft. Found this short video to be helpful and informative. If you'd like more information in regards to this 2002 Hunter 326 that's located in San Diego, California, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. Thank you again. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want more video walkthroughs like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.